topics on our...
Thank you, Marlene. Thank you, Central Asia Program and IRIS, for the opportunity to conduct and to deliver some findings of my research today. So, in my analysis of contemporary art sphere in Kazakhstan, I partly use the concept provided by German philosopher and sociologist Jürgen Habermas, public sphere. So public sphere is a space separated from government, from state, that brings private individuals together as public to generate debates about governing and the governed and exercise of power. But what is happening to public sphere in not so open societies with restricted freedom of the press? And I argue that in these societies, public sphere is extended to some other forms, and contemporary art and field of cultural production can be analyzed as a cultural public sphere. So let me go further. And I myself am part of artistic community, so I curated several exhibitions on themes of changes and transition. And to start the analysis of contemporary art in Kazakhstan, it's important to understand the historical concept. Art, fine art, was brought to the region by Soviets and Soviet rule. But not just art, it was a specific creative method, socialist realism. Here you can see the typical socialist realism painting by first prominent Kazakh painter, Abelhan Kostyev. You see the train arriving on the newly constructed railroad and local people greeting the train. So the painting by itself has a strong narrative. It symbolizes modernization brought to the region by Soviet rule and the way of acceptance of that modernization by people of the region. So socialist realism, it's not just art for art's sake. It's more a merge between art and ideology, between art and propaganda. It has certain aim, and the aim was to educate masses and to give the vision of the future. But at the same time, socialist realism give art certain social relevance. So art was placed in a wider social realm. In the government of independent Kazakhstan, to some extent, continues Soviet legacy in supporting ideologically relevant art. And here is the first part of a triptych, Mangili Kiev. That's the same name of ideological platform. And the triptych was commissioned by National Museum in Astana. It combines there are three parts, and the last part of it is a portrait of Nursultan Nazarbayev. So the whole triptych support the official policy in nation's state building. In my analysis, I focus mostly not on this type of art, like supported by government, but on contemporary art as a semi-independent field and contemporary artists as semi-independent actors, but that still create the art in a social realm, raising important social issues and cultural problems. And Saida Tabekov is one of these artists, one of the most interesting and most prominent Kazakh contemporary artists, who is a member of Kyzyl Traktor. That's the first art group who started working in contemporary art field. This work is a part of a big series, Kakpar, a traditional Kazakh game. And Said combines different art media. For example, here he used the original photography, but added some elements to that. And what he's trying to do, he's searching for a spirit, image, and language of nomadic society. And he, to some extent, reimagined that pre-Soviet society and pre-Soviet cultural rules and norms and locate them in today's contemporary world. Reimagining nomadism is a kind of big theme with many artists working within it, trying to evoke pre-Soviet symbols, norms, rules, and locate them in today's world. And Almagul Mendebaeva working a lot with image of nomadic woman. And her Madonna, or the Great Step, is a woman like on the intersection of cultures between East and West, and with a desire to be a part of the global and Western world, but at the same time with a desire to preserve and to find these local features. Another kind of meta-narrative that's closely related to the previous one is constructing new post-Soviet identity. And again, start with a work of Seyed Abekov, where he combines symbols of nomadic societies, then the like powerful symbol of contemporary and independent Kazakhstan, Bayterek. But the rocketing of Bayterek actually refers to the Soviet legacy and to the Soviet history as like it's referring to a cosmodrome or spaceport Baikonur built during Soviet times. So Seyed show us that identity is not a thing per se, it's rather a complex process, and it's a very complex construct that on which he somehow reflect. And he also shows us the process of transition, like from socialism to capitalism, again playing with different symbols and different media. Yerbol Mendebekov. Yerbol Mendebekov, very interesting, prominent, established Kazakh, a contemporary artist. And his work are sometimes ironic and you can call them postmodern. And here he reflects on Asian identity, who we are as Asians for the West, are we still the other, and also who we are for each other. And this work actually is called Brother Enemy. Well, there's a whole set of issues of regional integration, I think you can find here. Art theoretician Boris Groys said that contemporary art breaks status quo. So that's actually what this young street artist is doing. He intervening urban public space and with his artwork. And here is a work of Pasha Kas, Dancing, where he replicates the famous painting of Henri Matisse, made more than a century ago. And he replicated on an apartment building of Temirtau, single industry town in Kazakhstan. So somehow he's given us a message that we, as a society and as a government, still dancing around certain social and ecological problems. But he's not only intervening in public urban space, he's also working with abandoned sites and abandoned places. So that place is a symbolizing nuclear testing polygon. And here he replicates another famous Western artwork, The Scream by Edvard Munch. But his work is called This is Silence. And actually, This is Silence refers to a whole set of problems and lasting heritage of nuclear testing polygon in Semipalatinsk, but it's also a powerful message that there are silence around them in public sphere, and we are not discussing, there is an absence of public discussion around certain problems. And this silence was delivered in form of video, in form of artistic manifesto, and it was widely disseminated online. And the work by itself engaged people on discussions on online platforms, social networks, and it also was widely covered by local media, traditional media, and internet media. So it's gained wide coverage. And here you can see like the number of shares and likes. But not only online discussions trigger, not only artwork trigger online discussions. It also happened vice versa, and online discussions can result in artwork. Zoya Fedkova made this artwork about post-colonial condition in Kazakhstan after a very heated discussion with another artist on social media, Anvar Musyepov, about if if we can call a post-Soviet, post-colonial, what is the role and place of Russian ethnic group in contemporary Kazakhstan, and who should be responsible for the sometimes colonial abuse of power during Soviet period? So there was a very heated discussion online, and then Zoya come up with the artwork at the end of last year. And he plays with a quote from Dostoevsky, and I translate it is, am I a covering colonizer, or do I exercise my rights? Some conclusions. So contemporary art produce alternative narratives and discourses in the society. It gives us alternative vision and new meanings. It also engages people into discussions online, and it provides not a solid ideology, but rather a question that solid ideology and question that single worldview, through giving us the sense of complexity of issues that's happening like in the country. And through all that, art challenges them, challenges the state, and challenges prevents state from monopolizing and also monumentalizing public sphere. Okay, thank you.